Hey guys, for positive and refreshing content, do subscribe to my channel Divyanshu Damani and click on the bell icon to never miss any updates.
You played for the White House, you played for leaders like Ban Ki-moon, Mukesh Ambani. Most important question that people want to know, what is... I'm joining Penn Masala.
Cheers. Cheers.
Hello everyone and welcome to the Divyanshu Damani Show. Guests here are members of an acapella troupe comprising students from the University of Pennsylvania, USA. This group was started in 1996 by four students and have a legacy of over 21 years. Their music combines a unique integration of Western and Indian culture, and they have fans from all across the globe. Let's welcome Penn Masala. Thank you so much, guys, for joining me here today. It's a pleasure to have you on the show. With Penn Masala, we've got three individuals with us here today. We've got Nikhil Raman, who is born and brought up in New Jersey, and he's studying business at University of Pennsylvania. We also have with us here Atman Panigrahi. Atman is from Maryland, USA, and he's currently in third year at University of Pennsylvania, majoring in business and mechanical engineering. We also have with us here today Anvit Reddy. Anvit is from Dallas, Texas, and he is currently in his second year at UPenn, majoring in business. It is very evident from the quality of your content that it would take a lot of time to actually put the final product on YouTube, the final video on YouTube. So what's the time commitment like for you guys at Penn Masala?
Yeah, so different members in the group have varying responsibilities, mm-hmm. whether it's working on these videos, working on the music in studio,
right.
Or even maintaining our marketing efforts on social media. So based on those responsibilities and as work comes up, different members will have different varying amounts of time commitment, but all members share the same time commitment of practice during the week. Mm-hmm. So that's about four times a week for 2 to 3 hours. So each member has base commitment of around 10 to 12 hours a week, plus their varying subcommittee mm-hmm. responsibilities.
Right. You know, I just graduated from my college here in Calcutta, and one thing that I have noticed is that all college students have this huge pressure to balance between their academics and extracurriculars with so many seminars and assignments and things like that that we've got to submit. How is Penn Masala able to find the 25th hour to actually put such good quality content out there?
I guess, I can think this, but... I think one thing, especially coming off my freshman year, that I've noticed is that the group's very cohesive and mm-hmm. we rely on each other to not only do things and tasks that are related to Penn Masala, but also in school in general.
Right.
At least for me, I know that mm-hmm. I have some overlapping classes with seniors, especially Nico this mm-hmm. past semester. So like we rely on each other for studying tactics and possibly passing on any notes or anything like that and just helping each other study. And that's just an example of how we rely on each other on basically top to bottom, from Penn Masala to extracurriculars to schoolwork. And that's something that I think we've been able to build throughout as a result of the strong group bond that we have.
So it's basically the interpersonal relation that you have within the Penn Masala group is that keeps you going. And you're able to find the 25th hour to actually put out that kind of good content online. One thing that intrigues me is that have you guys faced any kind of trade-offs yet? It could be because of being a part of Penn Masala, it could be in the form of internships or time with friends or time with family or academics, whatever. Any trade-offs that you guys individually might have faced because of being a part of Penn Masala?
I think everyone in the group definitely has something that they have to give up at some point in time. For me, for example, back in high school, I swam a lot. I was like on a competitive swim team. And coming into Penn, I was like, I might audition or I might try and do club swimming. But once I joined Masala, I decided to commit more time to that. But I think I speak for everyone when I say that the trade-off is definitely worth it. And all of us really enjoyed making the music that we do and spending time with each other as well.
What is it, even despite these trade-offs, what is it that keeps you guys going?
So I think a big part of it is, pretty well represented by this tour, actually, is when we're making our music, sometimes behind the scenes, it can be You know, it can get frustrating at times, you know, putting so much work into it. But then when you get to go to a performance and sing these songs for fans, and see the impact that it has on them, and see how much they enjoy the music, how much it resonates with them, sometimes how it can help people get through difficult times.
Right.
We've gotten messages on Facebook, we've met with fans who really are touched by the music that we make, and I think that's a huge motivator for us to keep doing what we do.
You know, one thing that I've noticed here in India is that a lot of individuals, when they enter college, they drop their passion, be it art, music, sports, whatever, to focus more on their academics, to focus more on their career building. And moreover, there is this extra parental plus societal pressure that a lot of us face, that you can only go forward with these set occupations, be it a doctor, engineer, and music is something which you won't be able to monetize in the future. So you guys are the quintessential Sharma Ji ka beta. You've excelled in almost your academics, your extracurriculars, and things like that. Have you guys faced any such parental pressure when you told, hey dad, I'm joining Penn Masala?
I think, actually, interestingly enough for me, I've faced that pressure more in my later years in the group than in the beginning.
Okay.
At the beginning, my parents, especially my mom, was really excited that I was joining, you know, this group that would be performing and be in music. But as I got older, especially this past, I guess, year and a half, the time commitment for me personally has been a lot more than it was my first year in the group. And obviously, you know, whether I tried to hide it or not, my parents were aware of the like toll it was taking on me to some extent. My dad especially would be encouraging me, you know, like, just focus on school, you need the rest. But I think at the end of the day, like, it was the most important thing was for me to just be open and honest with my parents about like the importance of this to me. And you know, there are certain expectations they have of me in terms of academics or whatnot, and doing my best to meet those is what I can do to help them feel like
absolutely
I'll be okay in the future.
Right.
But at the same time, being honest and communicating with them, hey, this is something that makes me feel happy. This is something that's rewarding for me outside of school. Was something that, you know, over time they kind of finally understood, like, this is something that you'll care so much about, like, we shouldn't stop him from doing this.
Penn Masala, you guys have played for the White House. Played for leaders like Ban Ki-moon, Mukesh Ambani, Sachin Tendulkar. You've got millions of fans on social media and millions of followers worldwide. The most important question that people want to know, what is your GPA score?
Oh, boy.
Wow.
Do we want that?
I'm just kidding. You don't have to really mention what's it GPA like. But the reason that I made that statement was that in India, at least, we give a lot of stress on marks and marks only. So that's the only reason why I wanted to bring that out. And I'm sure you must be excelling with your scores as well. I hope so.
We try.
So both of us, I mean, both Penn Masala and even for myself, we are part of the social media community. And you know that this social media community can actually be savage sometimes with cyberbullying and online criticisms. So has Penn Masala faced any such criticisms in the past online which might have brought you down a little bit maybe?
So I think, you know, one example is literally last night, you know, as you and I talked about earlier, how we had to perform in Bangalore as part of our tour, but unfortunately we got rained out and the venue was outside. So, you know, we were trying our best to at least put on some kind of show for our fans. You know, we were out there performing in the rain, you know, literally doing everything we possibly could. But despite that, you know, there are some people who are kind of unsympathetic towards our situation, saying that the acoustics were bad, sound system wasn't good, and that we didn't sound, you know, at our best. So that's just an example, like, you know, something we do receive criticism on a daily basis. But I think it's just important for us to know that, you know, criticism, it is what it is, and to take it with a grain of salt and just keep on moving forward, because we know that there are a lot of people who do enjoy our music and who do appreciate what we do, and those are the people that we're actually performing for. Those are the ones that we continue to work as hard as we possibly can for every single day.
So I was watching this song of yours, Yuhi Chala Chal Rahi, and it was about how a senior is passing the baton to a junior who's taking the legacy forward. And that made me to think that Penn Masala is no more just a brand name, it's a legacy in itself. And for any legacy to sustain for such a long time, the values, the culture, the discipline of the seniors need to trickle down towards the juniors. So I'm intrigued to know, what's the succession planning process like at Penn Masala? And I mean, how do the seniors train the juniors so that the quality of content remains the same?
I think it's a matter of balancing, making sure we transfer knowledge, like transfer skills, whether that's in arranging music, filming and editing videos, or like photoshopping for our marketing. So part of it is, you know, having the, literally sitting down and teaching the way these like different software or different things are done. But the other half of it is more like giving people, I think we strive to make sure that people have freedom to take initiative in the group.
Right.
We talked about passion for a while, and each person's passion for the group looks just a little bit different.
Right.
And that can manifest itself in very big ways in terms of the content we put out. And so giving people some degree of freedom to explore that, bring pieces of content that they've been trying to work on to us as a piece of like, okay, this is what I've got right now. What do you think? Where do we go with this? Is this something we can use?
Right.
It's something that, one, fosters new abilities and new creative ideas in the group,
right,
and two, sets people up to lead the group well in the future, right? Because it's not just about sitting down with Anvith and teaching him how to use Photoshop.
Sure.
It's also about giving him the confidence to make a decision when
right.
he's the one who's the, who's the senior, right? It, just having the skills is meaningless unless you know how to be confident and lead the people who are under you in the group.
That's very well said. And we'll move on to the more fun-filled segment, which we have named Masala Magnet, for lack of a better name. Just kidding. So I'll be explaining what this game is all about. It's very similar to Antakshri. Let's say Nikhil is singing a song and the three of us are participating. Then we have to start a song from one of the words that Nikhil, from one of the words of the song that Nikhil has just sung.
Right.
Clear? And the person who is able to sing the maximum number of songs wins the game.
ये इश्क हाय बैठे बिठाए जन्नत दिखाए हाँ ओ रामा ये इश्क हाय बैठे बिठाए जन्नत दिखाए हाँ ओ रामा इश्क बिना क्या मरना यारा इश्क बिना क्या जीना.
I mean, anyone can sing. I'm not getting a song right now.
Jina, jina, kaise jina? Asika maine jina tere hamdam. Asika kabhi jina, jina, kaise jina? Asika kabhi tere bina hamdam.
Hum. रहे या ना रहे कल कल याद आएंगे ये पल पल ये है प्यार के पल
कहीं नजर में ऐसा जादू कर दिया तेरा मन बैठा है मेरा जिया जाने क्या होगा क्या पता इस पल को मिलने आज ही ले जरा मेरा मन कहने लगा हाँ पास आके ना तू दूर जा छूने दे होठ तेरे.
That doesn't
work. Yeah. So I've been practicing for this for the past 10 years.
tere bina beswadi beswadi ratiyan o sajna tere bina beswadi beswadi ratiyan o sajna ratiye mor ki re adure kade kadna oppo jan jana dhunde tujhe deewana sapno mein roz aaye aa zindagi mein aana oppo jan jana jaane kyon dil chahta hai dunya to I'll be alright aankhon mein teri ajab si adaaye hain oh aankhon mein teri ajab si ajab
so with that we come to the end of our segment Masala Magnet and it's time for the most important part the winner for today the winner undoubtedly has been the president of Penn Masala The juniors won't be taking it home. Congratulations, my man. Your gift for today is nothing. Nobody.
This is amazing.
Thank you for... We have to do it for the sponsors. We can't let Penn Masala go without a beautiful acapella song from you guys.
I stared up at the sun Thought of all of the people, places, and things I've loved. I stared up just to see of all of the faces, you were the one next to me. You can see the light start to tremble, washing what you know. Out to sea, yeah. You can see your life out the window tonight. If I lose myself tonight, it'll be you and I. Lose myself tonight. Whoa, whoa, whoa. If I lose myself tonight, it'll be by your side. Lose myself tonight. Aankhon ko teri aadat hai, dekhe na do inme shikayat hai. Chure chuliye tune mujhko diye pyar ke darane jaane aa ye jo ab ho raha hai kuch ajab ho raha hai kya yehi pyar ka ehsaas so aasmanon ko aur do jahanon ko chhod ke aaye tere paas so aasmanon ko aur do jahanon ko chhod ke aaye tere paas
All the best for all your future plans, Penn Masala, Nikhil, Atman, and Amit. Thank you so much, guys, for joining me.
Of course.
And since you guys come to the city of joy, we can't let you go without a Rasgulla toast.
Oh man!
Since it's a Rasgulla cheer and we are going the traditional way, we'll be using our hands.
Of course.
Yes.
Yeah.
And we'll be taking it in one bite.
Perfect.
Let's go, guys.
Cheers.
Penn Masala as an entity primarily shows us that if you're a student and are passionate and good at something, you can 100% strike a balance between your academics and extracurriculars. The group epitomizes that if you're a part of an entity comprising many people, you'll create massive success if everyone looks after the other and understands each other's needs. So take risks, manage your time, and don't forget to do what you love while balancing your academics.